Hello everyone, this is me Selena bringing you MCQs based on B.Ed. second year course 203. In this video, we will be discussing MCQs on unit 2 of this course. This is the second part of the video. To watch the first part, please click on the link you can see on your screen right now and then come back to this video. Question number 16, which is the least common type of cerebral palsy? Now, cerebral palsy is of certain types, so athetosis, spastic, dyskinetic, ataxic, all these are types. Out of this, spastic is the most common and ataxic, which is also known as ataxia, is the least common type of cerebral palsy. I will be explaining all the types further in the video. Question number 17. An ADHD child lacks the skills of paying attention. Give your opinion about the statement. Is it true, false, maybe, or I don't know? Now, the full form of ADHD is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Even though it says attention deficit, that does not mean that the child lacks attention paying skills. He can pay attention. Only thing is, he can pay attention, he cannot pay focused attention to a certain thing and sustain it. So, if suppose he is writing, he will write. And if there's any minor disturbance or something else attracts his attention, he will immediately turn to that. And that is why these children are quite fidgety. They are moving on from one thing to another because their attention is constantly being shifted. So our correct answer is option B, false. Question number 18. Why do ADHD children have difficulty following a multi-step instruction? Is it due to low IQ? Is it due to uninterest? Due to lack in consistency or due to impulsive behavior? Correct answer is option D, due to impulsive behavior. Because these children, they don't lack the sense of good or bad, right or wrong. They know what is good or bad, but it is in their nature to act before they think. So they'll do that action and then later on they'll realize that it's wrong and then they'll feel guilty about it. But till then the act is already done. Same thing happens when there is a multi-step step instruction given. So if you tell them first you do this, then you do that, then you do that, and you keep on giving instructions, that child has already started doing it. So he has heard your first step and he has started doing the activity and now he has not heard the third, fourth, fifth step. Hence, they are unable to follow multi-step instructions because they are so impulsive. They act before they think. Question 19. Dash and dash go hand in hand. One cannot exist without the other. Option A, ADHD and hyperactivity. Option B, knowledge and curriculum. Option C, inclusive schools and disabled children. Option D, diagnostic testing and remedial teaching. So option A is not our answer because certain ADHD children are not hyperactive, whereas certain children are. So there can be both the types of ADHD. Option B, knowledge and curriculum can exist without each other. We can have knowledge, right, without there being a curriculum. So that's it. Option C, inclusive schools and disabled children can also be there without each other. So inclusive schools can include other children besides disabled ones as well, like the marginalized children, etc. And disabled children can have a special school. They can both exist without each other. Our correct answer would be diagnostic testing and remedial teaching. Because if there is diagnostic testing, whatever problem is discovered needs to be given remediation and treated. Otherwise, it's pointless. And if you need to give remedial teaching, you need to know what is the defect, what is the problem causing point. And for that, you need diagnostic testing. So they go hand in hand. Question 20. What is the IQ score of a severe mental retardation case? Now, mental retardation or mental impairment is a intellectual disability and this is a developmental disability and this is found in children mostly below the age of 18. So now there are three degrees based on severity. So there's mild, moderate and severe. The people or children with mild mental impairment have a IQ range of 50 to 70. The ones who are moderate mental retardation has occurred have a score of 35 to 50 and severe will be 20 to 40. Thus, our answer is option C. Question 21, match. So on the left hand side, you have all types of learning disabilities. Learning disabilities is also a type of intellectual disability, just like mental impairment or retardation. Okay. And on the right hand side, we have the meaning in short of all these types of learning disabilities. So now let's match the two. First one, dysgraphia. Dysgraphia is writing difficulty. So you can remember this by the word graphia. So graphs, so writing. Okay, just try to remember that. Then we've got dyslexia. Dyslexia is a kind of language based difficulty. So these children have problem understanding words, phrases, sentences. Okay, so language problems. Then next is point three, dyscalculia. Dyscalculia, as you can guess, is problem understanding maths concepts. Calculia, okay. So difficulty of understanding maths concepts. Next we have dyspraxia. Dyspraxia is improper development of motor skills. Point number six. So their motor skills are not developed properly and hence they face problems in life. So that is called dyspraxia. Then the next one is non-verbal learning disability. Over here, that is point number two. Difficulty understanding facial expressions. Since they are not good at socializing and they have very poor visual and spatial skills, hence they are not able to understand even a person's facial expressions and take the message from it. So that is non-verbal LD. Next is visual processing LD. That is point number one, because they have a problem differentiating between similar numbers. So visual, right? They have a problem differentiating between what is written between numbers. Okay, and the next one is auditory processing LD, which is point number four, problem distinguishing similar sounds. So auditory problem. Done. Which is our correct option then? Just check and tell me. Seven means option B. 7, 5, 3, 6, 2, 1, and 4. Question 22. Is the cognitive ability of children with Asperger's syndrome hampered? Yes, no, maybe, I don't know. Now, Asperger's syndrome is considered a kind of autism. Here, the child has no problems with language. In fact, he is quite intelligent. He is either average or above average. But he has the same kind of social problems and limited scope of interest as children with autistic disorder. And hence, this is also considered as a type of autism. But he has no problems in his cognitive ability. Hence, the answer is option B. Question 23. How many levels of attention are there? 2, 3, 4, or 5? Answer is 5. So one is focused attention, where you can focus your attention and respond to any kind of stimuli, visual, auditory, or tactile. Tactile is touch. Then there is sustained attention. So if something is going on, some activity, you can give consistent attention to it and it doesn't like wander here or there. Next is selective attention. So there are multiple stimuli in the environment, right? But you can select the ones that are important for your activity and pay attention to that and ignore all the other stimulus. Then there is alternating attention. So if there is an activity where two or three things are simultaneously are being done, so you can alternate your attention. So you give attention to one thing first, you complete that, then you go to the next thing, then you go to the next thing, like that. And the last one is divided attention. So when you're doing two things at the same time, you can divide your attention and pay attention to both the things and do it properly. That is divided attention. So these are the five levels of attention. Question 24. Dash can be caused due to iodine deficiency, orthopedic impairment, intellectual disability, sensory disability, or cerebral palsy. The correct answer is option B, intellectual disability. Actually, iodine deficiency is a leading cause for intellectual disability. In school, we've also learned that iodine deficiency causes goiter, which enlarges the thyroid gland, right? So this is our answer. So we have studied a lot about disability and all the kinds and everything. So it gets a little confusing because there's too much of information. And hence I thought if I put it in a tabular format, it will be easy for you to understand and also remember. So let's quickly revise. Disability, we are going to study three types: sensory disability, physical disability, and intellectual disability. Sensory is any kind of disability in your five senses is known as sensory disability. So, and even spatial awareness is included under this category, but in your notes they have mentioned only hearing impairment and visually impaired impairment, and hence I have mentioned just those two. Then next is physical disability. Orthopedic impairment is the only thing that is mentioned in your notes, thus you need to study just that much. And under intellectual disability, you've got mentally impaired, learning disability, and that is LD, and autism. We will study each of them in detail in the next slide. Let's revise physical disability in detail. So under physical disability, you've got your orthopedic impairment. What is that? You remember we have discussed it in one of the MCQs that IDEA, Individuals with Disabilities Education Act, says that orthopedic impairment involve all physical disabilities which could affect the academic process. Under this, there are three types of orthopedic impairments: neuromotor, degenerative, and musculoskeletal. Under neuromotor, we have already studied cerebral palsy. Cerebral palsy are of four types. Spastic. The word spastic itself means tightness or stiffness. So there is a kind of stiffness in the muscles. This is caused due to damaged brain cells. These damaged brain cells cannot send proper messages to the muscles, and hence they remain tight or stiff. Second kind is dyskinetic. Dyskinetic is abnormal involuntary movements. There are three types in that also. First is dystonia, which means there is frequent twisting, okay, or repeated movements. Because of this twisting, abnormal body forms you can see in that person. Second type of dyskinetic is athetosis. Athetosis is when there is extra movement in the body, especially in the limbs and around the mouth area. Third type being chorea. Chorea is when there is rapid and jerky movements. Now, all these movements are involuntary. They are not done purposely by the child. Third type of cerebral palsy will be ataxic. Ataxic, you remember, is the least common, and spastic will be the most common. So this least common one, ataxic cerebral palsy, is when there is a tremors in the body. So the body is constantly trembling, or there is unsteady or shaky movements going on. And these people have a problem with balance as well. Okay. The last type is mixed. So it could be a combination of either ataxic with dystonia, or ataxic with chorea, or any combination of the three types of cerebral palsy. Clear, right? Spastic is stiffness. Dyskinetic will be involuntary movements, in which dystonia will be twisting. Athetosis will be extra movement in limbs, and chorea is jerky movement. Okay, and ataxic will be tremors. Clear? Moving on. Another type of neuromotor impairment that we need to know is spina bifida. Spina bifida also, I have told you, it is a developmental problem of the spine. So the spine is not developed of the child, and hence he has this disability. Moving on, let's go to degenerative impairment. There is only one that you need to know, that is muscular dystrophy. So as the name suggests, it's a degenerative disorder. So the muscles of that person are weak already, and they continue growing weaker. So they are progressively weaker. They weaken progressively. Clear? So the skeletal muscles, they degenerate, and this causes the disability. Moving on, musculoskeletal impairment. The first one that they have given in your notes is juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. This is a type of arthritis. So this child, who could be a teenager, has inflamed and stiff joints. So finger joints, elbow, knees, all the joints are a problem, like arthritis. Okay. The next is limb deficiency. Limb deficiency is a missing limb. This could be either by birth, or it could be a reason, it could be a cause of disease or any kind of accident. So a missing arm or a leg or anything. Then next is bone tuberculosis. I think I've already spoken about bone tuberculosis. It is basically tuberculosis that has moved out from the lungs and it has entered the bone, and that is that. And polio, like I've told you, it is caused because of a virus, and it can be easily cured by the polio drops. Remember, do boon zindagi ke, that. Okay, moving on. Now let's talk about intellectual disability. So intellectual disability are of three types: mentally impaired, MI, or mentally retarded, learning disability, LD, and autism. Okay, mentally impaired are of 3 degrees, like I told you, based on severity: mild, moderate, and severe. The IQ level of mild people will be between 50 to 70, moderate will be 35 to 55, and severe is 20 to 40. Okay. Then let's talk about learning disability. This also we did in the Match the Following, so I think you can refer to that slide. Okay. And autism. Coming to autism, there are two kinds of autism that we need to know. Autistic. Sorry, there's a spelling mistake in autistic. Autistic disorder and childhood disintegrative disorder. Under autistic disorder, we have already spoken about Asperger's syndrome. Let's talk about Rett syndrome now. So this primarily happens in girls, okay? And over here, the children develop normally, like they start off normally, but then slowly they start losing their communication and social skills. So that is that. And another thing is, unlike the Asperger's syndrome, these children are cognitively impaired too. Remember, Asperger's syndrome, they have no cognitive problem. Next, pervasive developmental disorder. This is also known as atypical autism because these children do not fit into any one category. So they show some autistic behaviors and hence it's considered as autism, but they don't fit into any category, and that's why put into this PDD category. Coming to childhood disintegrative disorder, these children also develop normally for the initial few years, and then they start losing their communication and social skills. But this disorder is extremely rare. Clear intellectual disability? If not, then please watch this slide once again. Question 26. In a buddy system, the relationship is dash. What is a buddy system? A buddy system is basically when two students are linked. So they are given a friend. Okay. So is it a one-way relationship, non-reciprocal, reciprocal, or unbroken? Now, in friendship, what do? You care for each other, you protect each other, you help each other, right? That is what happens in a buddy system too. And here too, it is not just one person helping and protecting the other. It is both way. So it is a kind of reciprocal relationship. So if one partner is helping the other in a certain area, wherever he is, wherever his strength lies, the other partner, in whichever field he is good at, he will help his partner in that area. So it is a reciprocal relationship. Question 27. Blended learning emphasizes on dash, teacher-student e-learning, or traditional learning. What is blended learning? In short, it is a blend of e-learning with traditional learning. So now there are various types of blended learning. So in that, the traditional part could be more, or the e-learning part could be more, or it could be 50-50%, etc. Okay, but what does blended learning do? Is the teacher constantly available and teaching everything to the student? No. So the teacher teaches in the class, or it could be the teacher gives e-learning material to the student. It could be videos, audio clips, etc., which the child has to listen at his own pace. So if one child requires 20 minutes to listen and understand, another child might do it in 10 minutes. So here the child has the freedom to learn at his own pace and at his own time, right? But the main thing is the child has to put in an effort to study it, and then the teacher can give guidance and whatever is required by the student after this is done. Right. So what do you think blended learning emphasizes on? It emphasizes on the student. Here, blended learning not only supports active learning by the student, but it demands it because the student is given the material and he has to put in his effort to understand it. If not, the teacher is always available, but the student has to put in a lot of effort. Question 28. Which of the following is not an advantage of blended learning for the teacher? Point A, flexible scheduling. Point B, professional development. Point C, new teaching techniques. Or point D, saves time. I think this most of you would identify with is it does not save time. Even if you're not teaching anywhere, you must have seen these multiple videos of teachers saying how this has kind of taken, it's like a vacuum. It's just sucked in all those teachers' time. They have no time left because there is so much of effort behind each and every 10-minute lesson also. There is lots of research, there is PPT making, or voiceover, etc., right? So it does not save time at all. The teacher needs to put in a lot of effort to make all the videos, games, slides, audio material that he gives to the children as e-learning material. Question 29. An IEP is made for Dash. IEP is an individualized education plan. Is it made for regular children, special education needs children, both option A and B, or is it for all the children? Well, it is not for regular children because they don't require it. It is for special education needs children because they have special education needs. This plan is a written plan. Okay, so all these people, that is the parents of the child himself, general education teacher, special education teacher, specialists, etc. They all sit together and formulate this plan where they set a goal for that child depending on his disability. Because it might not be possible for the child to achieve a goal as a regular child. So for him, there is a special goal which is attainable by him. And all the points that these teachers and special education people will do to attain that goal is also mentioned in the IEP. There are various other things also mentioned in the IEP. You'll have to read through your notes to know all of it. So is this much clear? Okay, let's go on. Move on. Question 30. In a circle of friends method of instruction, who is at the focus? A circle of friends method is also an inclusive technique like a buddy system. Okay. So now who is at the focus? Is it the facilitator, the friends, the disabled person, or the entire group? Well, the focus is the disabled person. This entire circle of friends is made for this person so that he feels included. So there are like 7-8 people who are the friends and they are this person's friends and they make sure that he feels included in all the activities, study, and they help him out. With that, we come to the end of Unit 2. It was a huge unit with lots and lots of matter. I hope I could make it easy for you and simple to understand. Please like my video, please share it with your friends, and if you haven't yet subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, all of you. I will see you in the next video.